Oh, g'day guys, it's Andrew from the Outdoor Gear Addict with a special review on a product that hasn't been released to the market space. Effectively, there's this local guy over here that's intending to produce these survival slash sort of micro sufficient fishing kits. And he's asked me to review the product and get some feedback from the YouTube community. So I'd really kind of appreciate it if you could try to share your thoughts with me in regards to this. And if you like the product, let us know, and I'll pass that sort of information on. So effectively, what we have over here is a micro survival slash fishing kit. It's really kind of designed to kind of replace this more sort of kind of comprehensive fishing slash food gathering kit that I have over here. And if you haven't seen this review before, click here to kind of check it out. But you know, the kind of big difference between this little micro fishing kit over here, which is fairly comprehensive, and this one over here, is that these ones over here have things like the auto fishing reels or mechanical fishing reels. And if you haven't checked these out or you haven't played with these before, these are a must-have, I think, items to have in your food gathering survival kit. So free feel to click here, check out the auto fishers. Feel free to click here to check out the review of the actual container. So on this one over here, really quickly, basically this one over here is really kind of about fishing, and you can have snare wire, and that's a really cool product. So check that review if you want to. But back onto this. It'd be great if you guys could give us some feedback in regards to this particular item. He hasn't sort of kind of finalized, I guess, what it's going to look like, and your comments are certainly appreciated. But let's start over here. This little item over here is, I think a nice little combination kit, and in my opinion, it's pretty logical and makes sense. I think there's a couple of things that are missing from it, but I'd be interested to get your feedback on that. So to start off with, there's a little case over here, and this case is really, really, really well constructed. It's got a thick element to it and a kind of thinner side to it, which is nice. So it's kind of breaks into a kind of thin area here and a thick area over here. So it creates some sort of nice organisational compartments. The item is only basically 4.5 inches in width, or 11 centimetres, and basically about sort of kind of, 3.5 inches, or about 90 millimetres, and about roughly about an inch deep, or 25 millimetres. So, this is a really easy, lightweight item. You can easily put it into your back pocket without any much hassle. It's really very, very light, so for what it is, it's extremely sort of micronized, well organized, and sort of kind of fairly comprehensive. So before I sort of dive into the actual box itself, he starts off by providing us with this kind of solar torch over here. So this one is it's a really nice bit of kit over here. It's got basically a highly well-constructed sort of carabiner kind of clip system. It relies on obviously solar energy, so you're not reliant on batteries and such like that. The lenses at the front are reasonable. It probably gives you about roughly 10 luminances, or around that anyway. 8 to 10 is probably a fair range over there. And quite a nice little torch. So it's good to have something that, is light, easy to carry. You can clip it onto your backpack, or you can keep it on over here. And, just that, that removal of reliance on batteries in an outdoor situation or a survival situation is really very important. So let's look at the actual fishing kit and case itself. The case opens up, and effectively it's kind of broken up into two sides. One is your kind of food gathering side on the right over here, and he starts off by basically providing us with kind of three loads of fishing line, going from really kind of heavy gauge fishing line over here, and you roughly got about 20 to 30 meters on each one of these spools, to the really lightweight ones over here, which has got about 50 meters, and this medium one here is about 30 meters, give or take, and then moves on kind of very quickly to provide us with a range of kind of smaller hooks over here like that. And small hooks are important to have, because you can catch big fish with small hooks, but you can't catch small fish with big hooks. So, it's a good starting place, definitely. And then sort of moves on to provides us with, medium-sized hooks, then into the larger ones. Now, in regards to weights and stuff like that, he's very, very cleverly kind of chosen these clippable, basically leaded ball pallets. And the reason why these are good from a survival situation is that not only are they easy to utilize and apply, but if you've got a sling or, you know, a ranger band, then you can use them as shot within that, and that sort of makes a lot of sense from there. So, you know, yeah, you can put more shot in there too, which is great. Now, saying that, he's given us a little bit more on, you know, the smaller, basically, lead weights. But, you know, really, I think they're a sufficient return, right? Really, what I like about this system over here is the redundancy that's being provided on the fire lighting as well as the torch light side. So, as you had seen before, you'd already given us a torch that wasn't reliant on batteries, that solar torch over there. I'll go back to the torches, but I'll touch on the fire lighting stuff over here. And he's given us a 4-inch ferrocerium rod, which will really kind of, you know, last us a day and a bit. To complement that, because you always need a bit of, you know, dry kindling to you know, help that spark going, he's also provided us with some twine over here, just some natural twine that you can sort of break up off, and you can make that into that kind of kindling, which is important. And he's given us another flame source as well. So instead of a spark, he's given us a flame, and it's very handy to have that big lighter. This Durex over here is this latex condom is kind of really a backup as a kind of water carrying source. So that's kind of handy to have, but, you know, obviously you'd want your own steel canteen along with you. What this kit doesn't come with is a knife. So if you, it's really kind of expected that, you know, you would most likely carry this kit in your pocket like that. And you'd have your own sort of, you know, belt clip knife or a folding knife that you would take along with that. And in that case, you know, this becomes more comprehensive survival/fishing kit. What he's also included over here is a button navigation compass, which is handy because obviously if you need to get some directions, that's kind of good. And obviously a thermometer too, which I think that, you know, most people sort of kind of understate. So when you're out there and you're, you know, becoming fatigued, as an example, you know, having an idea of the actual air and ambient temperature is really good, because sometimes, you know, you may think the climate's a lot colder and that's just you kind of, your body kind of running down. So it's nice to have a gauge of what's, you know, what is the real temperature around you. In regards to lighting, he's provided us actually two additional sources of lighting, starting with this really high-powered micro light. This micro light is amazing. Basically, it's 18 lumens. It's got three little batteries in here that will last up to 50 hours. So that's a really long runtime, considering the power output on that. And it's got a 2.4 meter throw, so this little thing will, you know, light up an area quite considerably. So that's a great little torch to have, but I'd kind of leave that in reserve unless you needed to use it, and I would be more reliant on obviously the solar torch until you really needed it. Now, in regards to signaling, he's provided us another whistle. A whistle, and there's a lot of whistles out there on the market, and you know, there's only sort of two whistles in my opinion that work really well. One is the jet scream whistle, and this whistle over here. This is just a little tin flute whistle, and it's got a really, really high pitch. So you know, you find that some of those, you know, water-based ones with, you know, the double flutes and them and stuff like that, they just don't seem to have that higher peak. In my opinion, this is probably one of the cheaper but more effective whistles on the market, bar the jet scream. The jet scream is certainly the probably best whistle that you can get. And then also what he's provided is basically this little 3-in-1 lighting system, where not only do you get a laser light, and if you are verbally or vocally incapacitated, this actually can be used as a signaling device as well. So that little laser will run up to about 50 meters. So it's quite a powerful little item. I'm really kind of surprised at it. Saying that, yeah, there's actually a torch light or two torch lights there. That's a UV version, and then you've got a natural or normal light version there. So you really kind of got three sources of lighting. You know, and I think that's a really kind of clever little inclusion to be in part of the survival kit. I think what's probably missing from this, to be fair, is you know, maybe some chlorinated tablets or some iodine tablets for water purifications, and I think you'd probably find room to fit that into the system. system. So guys, look, if you like this fishing kit, look, let him know. He's very interested in I guess, you know, determining if you know, this is a good product or not, and he would really like to get your feedback. As always, like and subscribe, and thanks for your time.